and welcome to our channel. My name is Mithri, and I'm a part of the Exactpro research team. At Exactpro, we build software to test software. I want to encourage you to check out our website for more information about us. And don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell button to make sure that you see the upcoming videos. We are continuing our series based on the ISTQB Certified Tester AI Testing Syllabus. Today, we will cover Chapter 7, called Testing AI-Based Systems Overview. We have dived deep into the process of developing AI-based systems and have learned that we can use metrics to assess the model's quality. But what about evaluating other components of the system? What else can we look at when we're testing such complex systems? We have to keep in mind that the testing process starts with requirements and specifications. System requirements and design specifications are equally important for both conventional systems and AI-based systems. Design specifications describe your software and its performance, as well as how the users should interact with it. System requirements specifications, on the other hand, specify what the software needs to do and how the system will perform each function. These specifications provide the baseline for testers to check against in order to verify if the system behavior aligns with what's expected. However, if the specifications are incomplete and lack testability, this introduces a test oracle problem when we need to determine the correct output for a given input. Let's look at the reasons why defining AI-based system specifications can be challenging. In many AI-based projects, requirements are specified as high-level business objectives and predictions. Often, AI-based system projects start with a dataset, with the aim to establish which predictions can be obtained from that data. So, development of these types of systems is exploratory. This approach, of course, is totally different from the conventional project when we determine the underlying logic from the get-go. The accuracy of the AI-based systems is reviewed after we get independent test results. This often leads to inadequate specifications as implementation starts before we establish the desired acceptance criteria. The probabilistic nature of many AI-based systems can make it necessary to specify tolerances for some of the expected quality requirements, such as the accuracy of predictions. Imitating human behavior can lead to poorly specified behavior requirements because all people are different and have different capabilities, which exacerbates the process of defining a test oracle. Where AI is used to implement user interfaces through natural language recognition, computer vision, or physical interactions with humans, systems need to show even more flexibility in documenting such interactions. Quality characteristics specific to AI-based systems, such as adaptability, flexibility, evolution, and autonomy, need to be included in requirement specifications. But since these characteristics are relatively new, this can make it difficult to define and test them. AI-based systems usually have AI and non-AI components. While we test non-AI components using conventional approaches, AI components may require something different. The biggest difference here is the inclusion of two new test levels to handle the testing of the input data and the models used in AI-based systems. All test levels that tackle AI components testing need to be closely supported by data scientists and domain experts. First comes input data testing. Its objective is to ensure the highest quality of training and prediction data. This includes reviews, statistical techniques, exploratory data analysis, and static and dynamic testing of the data pipeline. By the way, the pipeline is what we call the software responsible for data supply. The pipeline takes data from production, cleans it, and sends it to the environments where this data is being analyzed and the models are being trained. For example, it may be historical data for exchange rates or stock prices, or data describing financial transactions. Usually, the data pipeline is made up of several components performing data operation. And the testing of these components includes both component testing and integration testing. The training pipeline may be quite different from the data pipeline used to support operational prediction. For training, the data pipeline can be considered a prototype compared to the fully engineered automated version used operationally. Testing of these two versions may differ and should include testing the functional equivalence. Then we have machine learning model testing. Its objective is to confirm meeting the specified performance criteria, including functional and non-functional ones. This step also has to make sure that the choices of machine learning framework, algorithm, model setting, and hyperparameters are as optimal as possible. If applicable, machine learning model testing may also include testing to achieve white box coverage criteria. The selected model is later integrated with other AI and non-AI components. After that comes component testing for any non-model components, such as user interfaces and communication components. Then there is component integration testing that ensures that AI and non-AI system components interact correctly. Here we make sure that the data pipeline inputs function as expected, and that the model predictions are exchanged with the relevant system components. Where AI is provided as a service, it is normal to perform API testing of the provided service as part of component integration testing. The next step is system testing, which is conducted to make sure that the complete system, including both AI and non-AI components, performs as expected in a test environment that closely represents the operational environment from both functional and non-functional viewpoints. It can be done as field trials in the expected operational environment or simulator testing if test scenarios are hazardous or difficult to replicate in the operational environment. During system testing, the machine learning functional performance criteria are retested to ensure that the test results from the initial machine learning model testing are not affected when the model is added to the complete system. Here we also test many of the non-functional requirements as well. And lastly, we have acceptance testing that is used to determine whether the complete system is acceptable to the customer, even though this can be very complicated to establish for AI-based systems. So we have just looked at 6 levels of AI system testing. But as with any conventional system, there could come certain risks and potential problems. Let's look at some of them. There are several potential challenges in dealing with acquiring test data for AI-based systems, including big data can be difficult to create and manage. For example, it may be difficult to create representative test data for a system that consumes large volumes of images and audio at a high speed. Input data may need to change over time, particularly if it represents events in the real world. For example, when creating a model that predicts how long it takes to fix a bug, you need to consider that the description of bugs can be updated over time. Personal and confidential data may require sanitation, encryption, or redaction. Legal approval for use may also be required. When testers use the same data acquisition and data preprocessing methods as the data scientists, then defects in these steps may be masked. Incorrect or insufficient test data, and therefore inadequate testing of the machine learning model, can lead to the system providing people with imprecise predictions. In addition, there's a tendency for humans to be too trusting of AI-based systems decision-making. This misplaced trust may be called either automation bias or complacency bias, and it takes 2 forms. Accepting recommendations provided by the system without even thinking about other sources, and overlooking failures due to the lack of adequate system monitoring. For example, it is very important in finance and banking. Here, AI presents an opportunity to transform how we deal with credit and risk. Lack of rigorous testing and monitoring can easily lead to deepening of the existing bias, creating vicious cycles that reinforce biased credit allocation while making issues in lending even harder to find. In order to avoid that, we need to pay attention to documentation that describes the purpose of the system, architectural and design information, the specification of the operational environment and the source of any input data, details of expected system users, and the way in which the system is expected to adapt to changes in its operational environment. All of this needs to be clearly understood when testing. Functional correctness of untrustworthy inputs, explicit or implicit sample bias, flexibility, including the mislearnings from poor data inputs for self-learning systems. The typical content for the documentation of an AI component includes general information, design, usage, datasets, testing and training, and machine learning functional performance. One more problem that we can face is that the operational environment can change without the trained model being able to adapt. This is called a concept drift, and it typically causes the outputs of the model to become less accurate and less useful over time. Systems that are susceptible to it should be regularly tested against their agreed functional performance criteria to ensure that any concept drift is detected quickly. This can be done through retiring or retraining. Retiring is self-explanatory, and retraining is performed with up-to-date training data and followed by confirmation testing, regression testing, and possibly a form of A-B testing, where the updated B system is better than the original A system. AI-based systems risks can be broken into project and product ones, as it is for conventional systems. Project risks are connected to the machine learning development workflow. For instance, data quality issues can happen due to poor assessment during exploratory data analysis or corrupted data pipeline. They impact the next steps of the workflow, such as model training, evaluation, and tuning. As a result, the choice of a framework algorithm or model and settings or hyperparameters might be suboptimal. These risks can be mitigated by subject matter expert reviews, EDA, and dynamic testing. After a model is deployed into production, we start dealing with product risks that stem from the fact that the users might come across a number of issues related to the model's performance. If training data was irrelevant, it will cause the situation where the functional performance of a model in production differs significantly from the results at the testing stage. This happens frequently due to the overfitting. If the development team has incorrectly selected metrics for model evaluation, the end user may consider the model to be of poor quality, even though it shows satisfying results with the selected metrics. This is because all the metrics used to validate the model are artificial and do not always reflect the logic of the world around us. It also might occur due to the concept drift. In addition to that, AI-based systems might have non-functional performance issues when usability of the software doesn't meet users' expectations. Since all of these risks originate from the development phase, they can be resolved by improvements in the machine learning workflow. For example, subject matter expert reviews and relevant NFT activities. We would also like to highlight self-learning system risks. For example, the data used by the system for self-learning may be irrelevant. In this case, reviews by experts could identify the problematic data. The system may be failing due to the new self-learning functionality being unacceptable. This could be mitigated by automated regression testing, including performance comparison with the previous functionality. The system may be learning in a way that is not expected by the users, which could be detected by experience-based testing. And even if a model works perfectly, a user might be still unsatisfied with its lack of explainability. So it is critical for the stakeholders to understand how a model makes its decisions. This also might be considered a risk, especially in the areas such as legal and healthcare. And that is it for video number 7. If you liked it, give us a thumbs up. Join us next time. We will be talking about Chapter 8, titled Testing AI-Specific Quality Characteristics. As always, let me remind you that we do have a ton more awesome videos on our channel, so feel free to subscribe and hit that bell button. Thanks for watching, and see you soon!